So guys, I'm gonna show you how you can play online with GameRanger. So I'm assuming at this point that you have Command & Conquer Generals installed and that you've already used GenPatcher to apply fixes and that you have GenTool installed. If these things sound alien to you, then please check the links in the description because you do need that before going into this video. Now, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go to GameRanger.com and then just download GameRanger. Click Open Folder. Right mouse click and do run as administrator. Just let it install. Okay, and now just hit next, next, agree. And if you don't have an account, which would be for most of you, you have to create a new account. So just do new account. You can skip this and just enter your email address here. And just enter a password to your liking. And for real name, you have to always enter your real name. So I'm clearly Albert Einstein. And then go next. Profanity filters, an absolute nope. And click show cities from all time zones and just pick a city that's relatively close to you. Then just hit next. And it'll say account created. You just have to go to your email and activate the link. So let's do that. Go to your email. There we go, the GameRanger email. So click this link to activate. So we click the link. There we go. Account activated. Good. So we go to the setup. We click next. And look at that. We're logged in to GameRanger. Amazing. We have GameRanger news. Oh my God. So yeah, we could just ignore that. Nobody really cares. Anyway, so first thing you want to do is do some setting up, right? So the first thing is you have all these games. This is a lot of games. We don't care. We just want to see the games you have installed. So you just go to My Games. Ah, yes, so much better. So I only have Generals installed. So that's why I'm only going to see Generals games here. So these are all games. These are all players. These are all things going on. Now, quick piece of advice. You want to click this one once. This one. Oof. Okay. Okay, wait, no. One more time. There we go. So the ones that don't have the green dot are games you can join. And the ones with the green dot are matches that are currently being played. So you cannot join those because it's like, no, it's already being played. There we go. Does not allow late joining or something, which is fine. So you can join all these games. Now, the ping doesn't actually show as a number by default. So yeah, I like to change that. So just go to edit, options, appearance, and then untick this if you like just your ping to be as numbers. Then for the rest, you can switch off any sounds if you want. And there's voice communication, which I'm not sure if it works too well, but I think it does. And then over here in network, you can set the highest speed if you have decent internet. Another thing you want to do is on the system tray at the bottom right. So you got to click this up arrow. You got this. Okay, you got to right mouse click this, go to notifications, and then say friends game rooms only. Otherwise, you go mad because whenever somebody opens a room, you get a freaking Windows notification. So there you go. Now that you have some peace and quiet and you have GameRanger installed, you could theoretically just go forth and use it. But personally, I like to play in borderless full screen mode. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit my Windows key and type in GenPatcher and run it. And then yes, assign administrator privileges. And then go to additional content and go to GenTool and make sure borderless full screen is actually switched on. And then go to the playing online tab and click on launch the game in the window when playing GameRanger. There we go. GameRanger has now been reconfigured to run the game as borderless full screen. So yeah, let's join a game and see if it works. Always do allow access when you see the firewall. You might see this port restricted cone thing. Just click continue. And here we go. Now we've joined the room. I can say hello. And the guy's talking back. He's saying italics, sorry, which basically means if you look at his name, you can see it's slanted, right? It's in italics. That basically means I can't connect to him, but don't worry. There's a quick, easy fix for this. So I'll tell him, be right back. So I quit out of the room and I'm going to exit GameRanger. Now I'm going to open GenPatcher again. And I'm going to go to the playing online tab. And I'm gonna activate network optimizations. Now it's gonna tell me that there are some security risks, blah, 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 but I don't really care. So yeah, go for it. Then just sit tight. And now it's gonna tell me to restart my PC. Okay, fine, I'll restart my PC. Fine, fine, GenPatcher, we'll do it. And there we go, he's not in italics. So we can say, okay, let's start. Now it says waiting for host. So you just have to wait for him to start the game. And here we go. The game fires up. and it should automatically join the match. Now, if it doesn't automatically do it, you gotta click multiplayer and then LAN and just join the game through there. And there we go, he's starting the game. And everything seems to be working fine. And here we go, this is an online match right now. I'm not actually gonna play this game, so I'm just gonna tell him sorry. And we're gonna quit out. But yeah, that's how you join a game. And if you want to host the game, the steps are pretty much the same. You just click host, you choose generals, you say how many players you want, and then you give a description. And now we wait for someone to join. And here we go, somebody joins. I ask him, shall we start? He says yes. Okay, here we go. So again, multiplayer, network, and then create game. And that should be it. So let's put a nice map here. Let's do this one. Here he is. So I tell him I want to start. He clicks accept, and there we go. We play the game just as per usual.
Yes.
And here we go. This is a nice online game. Okay, he says GG. And there we go. Nice victory there.
We are victorious.
Okay, there we go. I showed you how to host a game. I showed you how to join a game. And yeah, everything working great. So if you do run into any issues, then make sure to check out leggy.cc/bugs, because there'll be some useful information over there. If you're still stuck or you're just looking for players to play with, then make sure to join the Discord. Link is also in the description. You can find cool players there to hang out with, to talk with, to play with. And yeah, that's going to wrap up this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Hey, guys, come on, give me a big fat like. And hopefully I will see you on the battlefield. That's gonna be it for today's video. Goodbye, guys. See ya.